Yeah, guys, and sorry for the call. Hopefully, I will release this one to YouTube. I don't know. We'll see. I'll try to talk some thoughts into the game as I go. If it's good, then all aboard. If it's bad, we're gonna sink this ship. So their champs isn't too horrible for me. It's actually really good. The support bought a potion to Lidl. I generally hate Echo because, okay, so he has the tendency to shove first. That means I need to answer the shove, or the wave gets into tower and I lose like the entirety of the wave, which essentially sucks. That's why I hate to play against this champion early. It's like Aurelion Soul. The Jarvan missed his combo, I don't know how, but I guess it happened. Luckily we managed to get him anyway, so it's fine. I'm not gonna last hit those because he was crashing before, so I can make him lose more minions and XP. He's running Ignite. I need to try and fin one of these downs because he will be getting in time back, but and start crashing in the wave. I'll most likely miss that one because I'm retarded with the Q. I'll skill my E so I can maintain the wave a bit better. I don't want to waste too much mana onto this. So I want the E to be up at times to last hit the ranged as well. He's dead again. The Jarvan is playing well. The Echo is kind of blind, which works in favor to us. But then again, he keeps shoving the lane to this portion, so he's always susceptible to ganks, which is good. So it's more his fault he's getting ganked rather than anyone like playing good or anything. Because he's shown the same tendency twice and been in the same position twice versus CC. So that's up to him why he's dying. I'm gonna get a pink for the Wraiths because it's in. This is like the best place to pink on blue, so your bot lane can't get ganked. But so far, I haven't really let the Echo crash, and my jungler has been decent into pathing and ganking for me because the wave has been around here, so it's been really easy for him. So that's all good. Okay. I mean, he does the thing in front of me, which does a sound and mana, so all I need to do is step behind. All I need to do is just answer his push. There's nothing more to do in lane. Because now, as you can see how he's playing more laid back because he doesn't want to get ganked anymore. So instead of pushing, he's gonna be like semi-pushing and standing more laid back. Which is kind of obvious because when he's been playing front, he's died way too much. Trust me, if I was 6, I would ult. Like, I keep watching the minimap, but I haven't hit 6 yet. Which kinda sucks. If it just was one wave later, the outcome would have been way different. Jarvan noticed his bot lane, so he's counter jungling him, which is fine. I should ward here too because he's most likely gonna come to see if he can clear his top side. So I can then just be wary of the Graves, because he shouldn't rush bottom unless he's really weird, like he kept a Gromp up and wanted to return gank or something alike. So for now I just need to answer the Echo because the Echo keeps shoving out but is standing more further back as explained earlier. It's like easy to detect how he's playing, like he's not gonna go to for too many trades and stuff because if he dies again I can start withering away at his tower or roam. So if he keeps dying he just become a burden to his team. But I'm not really like huge despite the two kills at this point, so it's still manageable from his position if he stops dying, and that's what he's trying to do. Gonna get a Dark Seal in case the game goes really good. Because buying a Mejai in lower MMR games is really fine due to people playing worse. I really hate Echo. It's so boring. Shove, shove, shove. I'm gonna miss that. Okay, despite Echo getting one kill, I got more from it. Our team got more overall too. Here I'm not really afraid of fighting him. But he just wants to rush mid and keep CSing. That was really good for us. I got Rod on my next back, so the game is in a really good spot for me. Echo is kind of so if I can keep shoving, it will be good. He cancelled his recall. Graves might be around mid, not that I'm too scared. He's gonna shield so he can try to get the wave, which is kinda random because it just allows me now to push it in with less threat on his end. I'm gonna get actually a lot of damage. I can spot both junglers, so I can play in proximity to it as I'm sieging. I'm watching the minimap. And now I'm just gonna keep shoving because I know the Echo is zoom, so I'm allowed to do this. I keep watching for Graves. And I'm gonna get first tower here because Echo is retarded. He can't back when I have so much damage early on. Like I have a Dark Seal that has 3 stacks. My blasting wand early on. Like, just look at the damage I'm doing early on. So he's just gonna lose the first tower to his, for his team for no reason. Because he didn't wanna back. I still get these random coughs, like I'm still sick, else I would have maybe talk more on streaming games. Well, the game has been going really well so far. I've been managed to counter alt once. I've been able to play with my team and manipulate the wave here, which set up two ganks, and eventually get a turret because the Echo refused to back. So far it's been kind of a standard textbook game. There isn't really much to like add or talk about. Like the things that happened from my point of view are pretty obvious to like note as to why they happened or why they were allowed to get my lead. I'm CSing also really well. But that's because how the lanes were maintained early. I didn't let him crash, so all I needed to do was just keep hitting the CS cleanly, and there's no worries in me missing too much. So the game is just going really solid for me. The jungler is fed, top lane is fed. Bot lane are, I mean, they're doing all right for being camped. I wouldn't say any bot lane has like a definitive lead. Gonna watch top. They're not gonna fight it out. Top turret is low. Jhin is by himself, but Brand is nearby. Bot lane is resetting. There isn't much for me to gank. Just gonna keep farming. Because I keep looking at minimap. As soon as I auto attack a minion, I flick my eye to the minimap. That's just how simple it is. Because I know as soon as I auto attack, I look at the minimap and my mouse cursor hovers here and then I click it. So auto attack, minimap, click. So it's just a small thing you do in game. Because I know the character is stuck auto attacking and then I flick the mouse and walk back after it initiates and I look at minimap. So I'm safe and I'm just covering vision on the minimap at all times. Just a small thing you can do. You don't need to do it excessively. But you can in situations you aren't pressured by your opponent. There are four people bot. I'm gonna keep stalling their backs for another tower. It's worth my flash, even though I initially wanted to see if I can 1v3 because they weren't too healthy or too great mana pools. The team should not get the inhibitor. That's actually worse for us. There's no point in getting the inhibitor early because it means we need to group. And they have Quadra wave clear. So us getting the inhibitor just denies us more. Like we deny a farm, a lane to farm at this point. Getting the tower is great, but at this point it's too hard to close out the game due to how the nature of how it works. Because then it means we need to dive them and there's no way we're gonna go ahead and dive like maniacs at this point. Brand seemed to find a nice camping spot there. What the fuck? I'm gonna get Mejai here. I don't feel too much threat going on to the game, so I can value safety. The fresh mist, the guy standing still. I just need to keep walking. Oh, I missed the Q because I'm retarded. That's my bad. For sure. Like, look, now none of us is can farm top, which just sucks for us. Oh my god. I thought he'd come top, not top to help us get the tower. Guess I was wrong. Now it looks like I'm definitely boosted. The guys are like, fucking hell, this guy keeps missing Qs. Kills Batman. Boosted mid laner. It's very unfortunate. Ocean is good for us when we're sieging, but I would have wanted to have any of the other dragons. What? Why would he flash? I mean auto range. Oh, they surrendered. That was a pretty boring game. I expected to comment more on it, but there wasn't much to comment. So sorry for that. I think I'm gonna mute mic for next one. My throat still is a bit off.